DJ John, live on the mix.
One eternity later.
Which will reach its culmination in the birth of the Messiah. This glimpse of the messenger will prepare the way of the Lord, fills us with joy and gladness, for indeed, salvation is so close. Brothers and sisters, let us acknowledge our sins and to prepare ourselves to celebrate the sacred mysteries. God of life, if the child was born of the Virgin Mary, you revealed to the world the radiance of your glory. Grant that we may celebrate in full and reverent faith this great mystery of the Word made flesh, who lives and reigns with you in the unity of the Holy Spirit, one God forever and ever.
From the book of Judges. There was a certain man from Zorah, of the clan of the Danites, whose name was Manoah. His wife was barren and had borne no children. An angel of the Lord appeared to the woman and said to her, "Though you are barren and have had no children, yet you will conceive and bear a son. Now then, be careful to take no wine or strong drink, and to eat nothing unclean. As for the sun, you will conceive in air, no razor shall touch his head. For this boy is to be consecrated to God from the womb. It is he who will begin the deliverance of Israel from the power of the Philistines. The woman went and told her husband, "A man of God came to me. He had an appearance of an angel of God, terrible indeed. I did not ask him where he came from, nor did he tell me his name. But he said to me, 'You will be with child and will bear a son. So take neither wine nor strong drink, and eat nothing unclean. For the boy shall be consecrated to God from the womb until the day of his death.' The woman bore a son, named him Samson. The boy grew up, and the Lord blessed him. The Spirit of the Lord steered him." The word of the Lord.
Thanks be to God.
Yeah.
I'm reading from the Holy Gospel according to Luke. In the days of Herod, king of Judea, there was a priest named Zechariah of the priestly division of Abijah. His wife was from the daughters of Aaron, and her name was Elizabeth. Both were righteous in the eyes of God, observing all the commandments and ordinances of the Lord blamelessly. But they had no child, because Elizabeth was barren, and both were advanced in years. Once when he was serving as priest in his division's turn before God, according to the practice of the priestly service, he was chosen by lot to enter the sanctuary of the Lord to burn incense. Then when the whole assembly of the people was praying outside, at the hour of the incense offering, the angel of the Lord appeared to him, standing at the right of the altar of incense. Zechariah was troubled by what he saw, and here he the readings today, dear friends, are reminding us God's ways are not our ways, and His ways are always better than our ways. In fact, they are the best for us. Let us all rise for the prayers of the day. The Almighty Father's generosity is immeasurable. In due time, He will grant the aspirations of His people. With confidence we implore Him, Lord, be gracious to us.
Thank you.
great sisters and brothers that by sacrifice of yours may be acceptable to God, the Almighty Father. Lord, mercifully join on the gifts today upon your altar, and by your power, consecrate what we bring to you in our weakness. We ask this through Christ.
Martha. Nasaan ka? Banda yan. Kaya mo. Ha?
Almighty God, we give you thanks for the gifts you have bestowed, created as a desire for blessings yet to come, that we may welcome the birth of Christ our Savior with free and devoted hearts. We make our prayer in the name of Jesus the Lord.
And notes related to the celebration of the 500 years of Christianity.
midnight masses scheduled at 6 p.m. and 8 p.m. On December 25 and January 1, castles will follow the Sunday schedule. And when we say that Misa Vigarios is 6 p.m., and that Misa Vigarios is 4 a.m., Mani po isa masunod sa Facebook live streaming ng Bath Manawa. The executive order of the city mayor in relation to the Misa Vigarios in Bangkali anticipated Misa Vigarios are as follows. Wearing a face mask and face shield shall be mandatory in coming to church. Those below 15 and 65 years of age, pregnant women, and persons with health risks are prohibited from attending masses. The number of persons allowed inside the church to attend Misa Vigarios at any given time shall not exceed 50% of its total capacity, to observe social distancing. The kissing or touching of images shall be absolutely prohibited during this time. And always bring an umbrella with you. Kaipang salam. Ang panalangin mo panalangin po sa naming matipumakong ng Diyos kung buwan ng kahanunay na nato sa ating kanya.
Please kneel and assist together and pray, O let us kneel with you now. God of our Father, we come to you in our need to ask your protection against the holy and indeed that has disturbed and even pained lives. We pray that you guide the people tasked to find yours for this disease and to stem its transmission. Protect the medical experts that they may minister to the sick with competence and compassion. We pray for those afflicted. May they be restored to health soon. Protect those who care for them. Grant eternal rest to those who have none. Give us the grace in this trying time to work with the good of all and to help those in need. We implore you to stop the spread of this virus and to save us from our fears. Grant all this through our Lord Jesus Christ, your Son, who lives and reigns with you in the unity of the Holy Spirit, one God, forever and ever. We fly to your protection, O Holy Mother of God. Do not despise our condition in our necessities, but deliver us always from all dangers, O glorious and blessed Virgin. Amen. Most Sacred Heart of Jesus, Immaculate Heart of Mary, Saint Raphael, Archangel,
pray for us.
Saint Rock, Saint Lorenzo Luis, Saint Pedro Caruso, servant of God to be known from you. Please pray. The mystery of faith.
Prayerfully lift up your life, including the ones that are resting.
us all, we pray, that with the Blessed Virgin Mary, Mother of God, with Saint Joseph, with the blessed apostles, and all the saints who have pleased you throughout the ages, we may merit to be good heirs to eternal life, and we praise and glorify you through your Son, Jesus Christ. Through him and with him and in him, O God, Almighty Father, in the unity of the Holy Spirit, all glory and honor is yours forever and ever.
Thank you.
Blessed are those called to the supper of the Lamb. Body of Christ.
Which will be fulfilled at their proper time.
Meanwhile, the people were waiting for a single island, and were amazed that he stayed so long in the sanctuary. But when he came out, he was able to speak to them, and they realized that he had seen the vision in the sanctuary. He was gesturing to them, but remained mute. Then when his days of ministry were completed, he went home. After this time, his wife Elizabeth conceived, and she went into seclusion for 5 months, saying, "So the Lord has done for me at the time when he has seen fit to take away my disgrace before others." My dear friends, the gospel of the Lord.
Thanks be to God.
Mag-iisuon maayong gabiin na pagdanan.
May gabiin sa
for the fourth day of our designated mystery time, we are invited to listen to the account of St. Luke about the birth of John the Baptist, including the mysterious circumstances surrounding his birth. As we all know from the gospel account, his parents, Zechariah and Elizabeth, belonged to the priestly tribe of Israel. They were very pious and faithful people according to the standard of the Jewish religion. They might have been contented with a meaningful marital relationship, but they could always feel that something was lacking. They were not blessed with children. It was a difficult reality on their part because for the Jews, inability to bear a child was a sign of God's punishment. Giling kami mag-anak ang sa katao at sa kamatayon, nagpasabunta ang Diyos, wala mag-inuot kanina. Kung posible mo na, sigun sa pagkuko sa mga Diyo, isirutan ito mo sila sa Diyos. Buat ninyo, alam ni Zechariah at Elizabeth, because they were pious people. They belonged to the Levitical or priestly class of Israel. Hence, this was really a cause for shame, especially on the part of Elizabeth. But through the years, Zechariah and Elizabeth gradually became at peace with this reality that they could not really become biological parents. Unexpectedly, God surprised them with the good news that Elizabeth would bear a child in her womb despite old age. This was a truly mind-blowing development on the part of Zechariah. He could hardly believe and understand how this reality would eventually take place. Tingali ko sa atupang sinuntian. Karoon ba man yung noon? Tigulay naman ito. Isang kita ninyo sa mga asawa ko na niya, dugayan sa ninyo mga dugay ko rin. Thus, God made Zechariah mute for some time. When God made him speechless, it was not actually a punishment according to Bible scholars. It was actually a help. He was given the gift of silence so that he could slowly digest and figure out the mysterious intervention of God in his life and family. Kurang buk-at rin kaayo ito ang maghintabog. Dako ang rin kaya maghintabog panibuhat sa Diyos kaya pinagawin na kusang religyoso matubuhod ng tao sana ni Sakarunas maglisod sa religious. Thus God felt that he will give him the gift of silence. This particular gospel experience is also reminding me of my experience early on in my recently ministry. When I was doing my day, marami tayo may nilisan. Ang aking pangalaway na masay ng pusaka, remote far-flung mga area
Nemagandang sinayos ko ang mga yato ng mga bagong bukos. Huwag nyo na ang ako ng kalendary ang unang-unang. Bakal mo pag-ugay ko, no? Kaya pa nalang ugay. Kaya pa nalang ugay ko sa pedisyo. O sa'yo ang isang pedisyo, no? After all, bakal mo makaaya ko, no? Unfortunately, that desire was not materialized. For the first 12 years in the ministry, I had been assigned in the city in Babylon Ministerial Capacities. I-assign ko sa hospital, I was moved to the seminary for 9 years. So there I was asked to be a spiritual companion, a provincial companion to seminaries. There was also a time that I was sent to Manila for special studies. Sa panahon ng mga kalibot ako, nang nalagay ko yung ma-assign ko yung murang mission na trabaho. Nakadawat ko sa mong first appointment as Spanish priest at Abadante Paris in Southern Mexico. Kung si Father Domi Guzman de Consultigon, kumintante, no, ang Ginoo. Kumintante ang Ginoo, ibadali ang kumusulot niya. Sama ko kailangan natin, makaginuha, makakumintsa ko tayo sa mga suod na punta. Kapansaray ba, hindi ang Ginoo ko sa tinapot na ang Ginoo, ano na yung plano at alam sa tagsatag sa kanan? Yes, we have plans for our life. But it is also good to recognize that God has created plans for us. Like St. Maria and Elizabeth,